Hello students. I am Ajahn Phom Phom Nisaiman. We meet again in the second EP. For this video clip, I will talk about type of process control. First of all, I would like to show you this mind map. For last video clip, we studied about BPCS or Basic Process Control System. You already know what is PV, what is MV, and what is disturbance of the process. And you already know what is the main part of the control system, right? For today, I will talk about type of process control. Besides of feedback control, we also have another technique of process control as well, which I will tell you in this video clip. And these two topics will be lead to the next topic, which is PNID. What is PNID? PNID is a type of drawing for instrument engineer or instrument technician. I will show you how it look like. Here is the example of PNID. In last video clip, you may saw some small PNID, right? But this is the larger PNID. But in real life, it may be more complicated than this. Okay, what is I want you to understand about the PNID is I want you to know that what is the part of an control loop. Okay, and what does it mean for each symbol? Okay, you may confuse about my face is change color because I record this video clip in the night, and sometimes it's white, sometimes it's yellow. Okay, yeah, so okay, I want you to know what does it mean about each symbol, and I want you to analyze it and specify what kind of process control technique that it used to control. That's why we have to study this topic first. Okay, we have to know the type of process control first, and then you analyze it in PNID. What type of process control that is in the PNID? Okay. First, I want to show you the answer of the last assignment. Okay, this is the example. For this process, PV is pressure in tank. We know that because the transmitter is pressure transmitter. So the PV should be pressure in tank, and the MV for this process is outlet flow. I already told you the technique to identify what is MV is to say the control valve. What is it controlling? Now it is controlling the outlet flow. So the outlet flow is the MV for this process. And if you want to know what is PV of the process, you can see from the transmitter type. For this process, it is pressure transmitter. That's why the PV is pressure in tank, and the disturbance for this process is inlet flow. Okay, inlet flow. So how this process work? We measure the pressure in tank, and the controller control this control valve. If the the pressure in tank is low, then the control valve is closed to increase the pressure in tank. But when the pressure in tank is high, so this control valve should be open to release the pressure in tank. Anyway, beside the flow outlet that can we make change the pressure in tank, the flow of inlet gas also make change to the pressure in tank as well, and we call it disturbance because we can control it. Okay. Next, for this process, the PV is temperature of fluid in tank. We know that because this is the temperature transmitter that measuring the temperature inside the tank. Okay, and MV for this process is flow of steam because the control valve is in the steam line here. And this disturbance for this process is flow of feed in, flow of feed out, temp of steam, right? Temp of feed in and level in tank. These are all disturbance for this process. Okay, so how is this process work? The temperature in tank is controlled by the flow of steam. When the temperature is low, then this control valve should be open to allow the steam to go into the tank. And when the temperature is high, so this one should be closed, okay, closed or open just a little bit. Actually, this valve can open from 0 to 100% in 5 step, okay, 0%, 25%, 50%, 75% and 100%. That is 5 step for control valve. Okay, and of course beside the flow of steam here that make change for the temp in tank, flow of feed and temperature of feed, even flow of feed out and level in tank also make change to the temperature in tank as well, and we call it disturbance. For this process, the PV of this process is level in tank because this is level transmitter here. Okay, and MV for this process is flow outlet. This one is pump. Okay, sometimes final control element can be control valve or pump or another actuator. Okay, in this case the final control element is pump, and this disturbance for this process is flow inlet. Okay, so how is this process work? To control the level of liquid in tank, we can control by adjust the flow outlet. Okay, when the the level in tank is low, so the pump should be work at low level. When the level in tank is high, so this pump should be work in high level. And the level in tank can be changed by the liquid in the inlet line as well, that we call disturbance. Okay. Next, this is another process. This one called furnace. Okay, furnace. The PV of this process is temperature of feed out here, because it is temperature transmitter, and the temperature here controlled by controlling the fuel. When the temperature low, we can open this valve to let the fuel go to the furnace, and when the temperature high, we can close this valve or open this valve just a little bit to reduce the fuel for the furnace. And this advance for this process is temp of feed inlet and flow air here. Okay. I hope you will make the assignment correctly. But if you answer it wrong, no problem. It's just exercise. Okay. All right. I will go to the topic for this video clip. Actually, we have six type of control technique, or actually last video clip I only talked about the feedback control or closed loop control, right? I will review it again for you, and then I will talk about another technique for another process control. For feedback control, we have four main parts here: process, measuring device, controller, final control element. Okay. Process can be a tank of liquid or furnace or heat exchanger, anything. And PV is the thing that we would like to control, is such as temperature, level, pressure, or flow. Okay. And here is measuring device to measure PV, and then send the standard signal that core present TO to the controller. Controller will compare to the SP or set point, and then send signal to final control element, and final control element adjust the MV. When MV change, then PV change as well. Okay, this is the example of feedback control. This is a heat exchanger process, and here is PV, temperature. Okay, and this is measuring device, this is controller, this is final control element, and flow of steam is MV, and flow of fluid in is disturbance for this process. Okay, this is feedback control. Next one is feed forward control. The problem of feedback control is sometimes is too slow, because because it have to wait the PV to change first before it measure the output and feedback to input or feedback to controller. So it's slow. It have to wait until PV change first. But for feed forward it will not wait until the PV change, but it will measure this turbine and then adjust MV in advance. Okay. For example, this process, can you remember? In feedback process, we measure PV here. Okay, and feedback signal to the controller, and controller adjust flow steam. This is the feedback control, and it's slow because it have to wait the temperature here to change first, and then adjust the flow steam. But feed forward can work in advance because we will measure the disturbance here, and then the controller will adjust the flow steam in advance, and no need to wait the PV to change. That's why it can work faster than the feedback process. Okay. Anyway, some limit or some problem for this technique is the controller have to more efficient. Okay, if it if it's not put in a right solution, so the PV maybe not go to reach the set point. You know what I mean. If we not set the control good enough, so it may adjust in a it cannot just adjust the steam flow correctly, then the PV cannot reach the set point. Okay. So here is the block diagram. Here is this turbine. You can see the measuring device measure the disturbance and then send signal to feed forward controller, and then feed forward controller send signal to final control element, and then it will adjust MV, so PV should be changed. But we don't know that PV is reached the set point or not, right? Because we don't have the measuring device to measure PV here. So the point is controller function. It should be set in correctly. Okay. To improve the performance of feed forward and feedback, we can use it in combine. The good point for feedback is it can make PV to reach the set point correctly, but it's slow, right? For good point for feed forward is use less time or faster than feedback, but the bad point is it maybe cannot make PV to reach the set point correctly. So we will use feed forward and feedback in combine to make it more perfect. Okay, we will use the two technique like this. You can see loop 01 is feedback loop and loop number 02 is feed forward loop. Okay, for feedback we measure output here or PV and then send a signal to temperature controller and then it compare to set point and then send signal to FY02 is like a function mathematic function. Okay, and here is flow transmitter to measure this bands and then send a signal to feed forward controller and then two signal here will calculate. In this case it is summation. Okay, and then the signal here will send to the final control element and adjust steam flow. So by this way we can increase the efficiency of this process. Okay, it more accurate and faster. Okay, anyway, according to it used two sensor and two controller, of course it use more budget. So sometimes we don't need to invest like this. Maybe just feedback control is okay. But in serious process, you can use feed forward with feedback control. Okay. For this block diagram, you can relate to this picture by color. For example, pink here is FT02. The violet here is feed forward controller. The green one is should be here, I think. Okay, and H1 is here, the blue one is controller and the red one is process. Okay, next one is cascade control we use when we have two process that will work together. It's like a sequential process. For example, these two process, we have process 1 and process 2. Process 1 is main master process and process 2 is slave process. For master process is to mix, actually it is reactor is the equipment when the reactant go to it and has some reaction inside. This you can see it has like a mixer here. Okay, and for this process, the reactant should be warm first before go to this process. Okay, and we have another process here, preheater furnace. We have to warm up the reactants before let it go to the reactor. Okay. Why we have to warm it first? Because if we let the cool reactant to go inside the reactor, it will take time, because sometimes we have to take time to change the temperature of the reactants from cool to hot. Okay. So how to reduce time in this process? We just preheat it before let it go to the reactor. Okay. For the master process, you can see measuring device here, temperature transmitter, measure the temperature inside the reactor here, and then send the signal to TC01. Okay, and then the TC compare to the set point, and then send the signal to TC02. TC02 is controller of this process. So the signal that sent from TC01 will be the set point for TC02. Okay, so it means the set point of TC02 can be changed in any time. Okay, and for TC02, it control the temperature outside the preheater by measured by TT02 here. If the temperature is low, then the controller will open this valve to let the fuel flow go to the preheater furnace. Okay, and when the temperature is high, then the TC02 will close this fuel or open it just a little bit. Okay, anyway, the set point for TC02 will be related to TC01, okay, which is the main process. Okay, this one is called cascade control. And below here is block diagram for cascade control. For the slab loop or slab process will be inside, and the master process will be outside here. Okay. Next one is ratio control. Ratio control we use when we want to mix two type of fluid in a specific ratio. Okay, for example, 1:2, like this. For this process, for example, we want to mix the color green color, right? We have to mix the color between yellow and blue. Okay, and we have to make in a fixed ratio to control the green color output, right? For example, this process, we have fluid A and we have fluid B here, okay? And we have flow transmitter 1 and flow transmitter 2 to measure fluid A and fluid B. And then you can see FY1 here, it is like a ratio of this ratio control. In this case, the ratio is FA divided by FB. For example, if the flow of FA is 10 and the flow of FB is 5, so the ratio is 2, right? Because 10 divided by 5 is 2. Okay, and here is the flow controller, and this is the control valve. This control valve will adjust flow of fluid B according to this ratio FA divided by FB. Okay, and this is the reactor to mix fluid A and fluid B together. And below here is the block diagram. This one is FT01 to measure flow of fluid A, right? And K is here. K is like a ratio of this mix. Okay, and this one is FT2 to measure fluid B. Okay, and the green here is FC2. And the blue one is control valve. Okay, so summary. Fluid A can go to this mix reactor, and we just adjust the fluid B in the ratio here. Okay. Next one is override control. Override control usually used for safety. How it work? For example, this process, we have the tank here, and we control the level in tank by measure by LT1, and we want to control flow outlet as well. We has flow transmitter here to measure flow outlet. We want more flow. Actually, we want control flow outlet flow here, but the level in tank we have to control as well. When the level in tank is high, we can increase flow outlet, but when the level in tank is low, flow outlet should be reduced as well. So how can we control like this? We use override control. You can see FY01 here, right? And you can see this symbol. This symbol is less than, right? The condition to control this pump is which one is less than another one can be control this pump. For example, if the level in tank is 25% and the flow outlet is 75%, so which one is less than another one? LC01 should be less than FC02, right? Because the signal from this transmitter is 25% and the signal from this transmitter is 75%. So this controller can be control this pump. So this controller should control this pump to work in a low level, okay, to increase the level in tank. Okay, in another situation, if the level in tank is 75% and outlet flow is 22%. So which one is less than another one? Of course, FC02 is less than LC01, right? So FC02 can send signal to control this pump, and of course it should be turn the pump on and work in a high level to increase the outlet flow here. Okay, this is how the override control work. And this block diagram show you how it work. This is the process, right? And we have two matching device, level and flow. Okay, the signal goes to the controller. The controller send the signal to this one. This one is FY01, and the condition is less than. Which one is less than another one will be able to control this final control element. For this is case is pump. Okay, and the last one for the type of process control is selective control. For example, in this case is like a pipeline. You can see cooling water here, and this is the way that reactant go through. Okay, and this one should be the like a hot wire. Sometimes in a long distance, the temperature may be not equal. Sometimes in the middle, hotter than the left and the right. Okay, so sometimes we have to install more than one matching device. In this case, we have three: TT1, TT2, and TT3. Okay, and we have FY here, and this symbol is more than, right? So the condition for this process is which one of three, anyone, which one is more than another one can send the signal to PC. Oh, I think it's wrong. It should be TC, right? It should be TC because we measure the temperature. This is it should be TC, temperature controller. The temperature controller will control the flow of cooling water. So this process takes serious for the high temperature. So they put the three matching device into the pipeline, and then select only the most signal from these three matching device to control cooling water. Okay, anyway, in another case we can change the condition here. Sometimes we can make the condition like less than, more than, or average, whatever that you want. You can decide this. Okay, but for this example, it takes serious for high temperature, so that's why they put the condition more than here. Okay, and the lower here is block diagram. We have three sensors to measure temperature from the same process here, and the output from each matching device go to this and select which one is more than the another one will go to the controller. The controller will compare to the set point and then control this control valve. and this control valve will make change to the flow of cooling water. So the PV of process should be changed as well. Okay. Okay, I forget to show my face. This is the all of this EP. No assignment for this topic, but in the next time, I will show you homework next time. Okay, next time we will talk about PNID. Okay, and then I will give you an assignment like this. Actually, we have another PNID as well. This one is just an example. From this PNID, I want you to analyze analyze control loop from here. For example, you can see one loop, one control loop here. You can see FE, FT, FAH, FAL, FRC, FY, FCV. Okay, this one is one loop. I want you to prepare highlight pen as well. I want you to print it out and then use the highlight pen to highlight the loop. Okay, like this. For example, okay, you highlight it like this. Oh, actually, you can do homework by your computer. Okay, you just highlight this and then tell me what type of this contone. Okay, can you tell me what type of process contone? Of course, feedback contone. Yes, you write or type in the space like this, and you type like feedback control, and FCV mean flow control valve, something like this. I next time I will teach you first what does it mean for the letter here. Okay, and sometimes it has more than one loop. You have to find it out all control loop in the one page. Okay, this is your next assignment, but for today we don't have the assignment. Okay, you can study from this video clip, and if you don't understand, you can look at it more than one time. okay, so I hope you will understand what I deliver to you. If you don't understand in any point, you can ask me. Okay, see you next time. Goodbye.